Must come out in the light. July 28th, 2015. What you grateful for, family? Attitude of gratitude. Tuesday. Woo, you are tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living. I'm Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks, pioneering Nest Health Wellness Bioenergetic Practitioner, Conscious Self Healthcare Educator. No, I'm not a medical doctor. They call me Dr. K, pioneering educator in the field of quantum health and healing, conscious self healthcare, founder of the Art of Self Healing and Self Help. Health Education for Longevity and Peace is a health wellness maintenance organization for the prevention of disease. We share information that illness are no longer seen as diseases. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That cannot be cured and that must be managed by pharmaceuticals and unnecessary removal of organs and the amputation of limbs. You see, the current paradigm in healthcare is now seen as outdated, buried disease thinking. No longer a viable way to care for the well-being of this human being, of this human frame, because we truly understand the power of conscious self-healthcare. So often it's in the seeming breakdowns when we start going through things that the greatest breakthroughs are born. We get to realize and visualize and understand that we no longer need to hold on to those old paradigms of thinking that's no longer serving us. Diseases are recognized as scrambled information, distortions in the human body field, breakdown in physiology, not giving the cells what they need to regenerate themselves at their optimal potential. But mostly, as part of a belief system, something that you have been learned, something that you have been taught, that you have been told to believe in, created by the ways in which you choose to care for your human frame. So if it's not what you really want, you no longer want to hold on to that vibration and no longer serve you. It has become a lower frequency. It's not vibrating high. Give yourself permission to let it go. Let it go. Like, let go of the terms that we have been told that it's in the genes, because it's not in the genes. It's in how the genes are taught to express themselves. And you control that for your own being. Nobody else's, your own being. So how do you want to express your genes now? You know, the body rejuvenates itself within a year, within 2 years. Every portion, every part of it, every cell, every organ regenerates itself based on your own thinking, how you fuel your body, what you put into it. Expanding our awareness with the new information on well-being gives us the opportunity to refine certain aspects of ourselves and our experiences and become healthier as a result. Are you ready to get healthier? Are you ready to be stronger? Are you ready to have endurance? Yes. I'm Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks, broadcasting live from Washington, D.C. in downtown Anacostia, and I love it.
being here in this vibration of Cedar Hills right around Frederick Douglass' home. It has this energy that propels you to know that health is all about consciousness and healing is a function of consciousness. You see, we can quickly bring ourselves back into alignment with the most authentic part of ourselves and nurture ourselves back into our own healthy living through our thoughts, our consciousness, our diet, our lifestyle, and having access to proper information to always allow ourselves to evolve into our greater selves. Family, community, and friends, are you ready to get radical about your health care? Are you ready to take back control? Once again, health is all about consciousness, and healing is a function of consciousness. And on this show, every Tuesday, we ask you to remind yourself, are you working from a man-made mindset of human consciousness? Are you ready to break those chains that bound you into that belief system, that value system, that want to be a part of the sheep, the herd? Are you ready to be your true self? Are you ready to vibrate to that feeling inside of you? You see, here we share conversation, music, poetry, enlightened articles, and interviews with wonderful individuals that are sharing conscious self-health care information to empower you to take back control of your health care. We're here with Pamela Burscak today, again on our Burscak. I knew you was going to do that. That's why I'm glad you opened. Thank you very much. Correct me. I love it because everybody knows I can't pronounce what I see. All right, Burscak. I love it, Pamela. Pamela's here. This is her second time around. We're going to expand the potentials of what we did last week. And so we also hold the space for you, the listener. This show is for you. It's what I do for myself, so I give you the platform too. If you have uplifted yourself, if you have changed your paradigm from thinking, if you are no longer a victim to disease care, you have made some changes, you value yourself and who you are and that you control your body, we want you to come on this show and share your story and how you did that so you can be a help for someone else. So I'm holding the space for you. This show is for the community. Heart-to-heart information for a healthy living. And once again, Pamela Burscak, a life coach, lymphologist, and the author of Endless Breath, Boundless Energy. We're two lymphologists, and we are sharing the information on cellular wellness, lymphatic cellular wellness. And we're going to talk to you again about how you can maintain that greater level of wellness. So whatever your game is, this should be the first. That's what Pamela says. This should be the first, whatever your game is. Hey, definitely. We want to understand about the lymphatic system, cellular ecology. We're talking about keys to long and healthy life. And just briefly, a couple of keys to keep in mind as we move through this next phase of what we're working through. We're talking about consciousness for health, health quality, nourishment should be number one. The physical body survives not only through your consciousness, which is number one, but physically how you take care of it, what you put in it and what you put on it is crucial to how it functions. And when you have toxicity that sets in your body because it's not able to purify itself in a timely manner, we're talking about rapid removal of toxins. And we're going to show you how to do that. We're talking about creating copious amounts of oxygen that penetrates deep down into that flooded area and lifts up that oxygen so that you can move and create the power that you want. So we're talking about oxygen pumps, electricity, and power. We're going to take a commercial break. Pamela is going to come back and share with us, and we're going to explain to you about the science of lymphology, vertical movement, and how to cleanse and purify your body with the power of the breath that moves the lymphatic system. Do you feel lost? Do you feel out of sync? Could it be that you are experiencing electromagnetic sensitivity? Yes, electromagnetic sensitivity. Could man-made frequencies interfere with cellular activity and melatonin production? We are beings of frequency, light, and information, and you are your own experience.
Do not conform any longer to the patterns of man-made mindsets of human consciousness. Be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Schedule your NEST Provision Human Body Field Scan with Dr. K, 202-248-7749. Visit the website forcellife.com, the number 4CELLLIFE.com. Have the courage to expand your horizon and reprogram your cellular activities. Call Dr. K for your 15-minute wellness consultation, 202-248-7749.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's smooth music. I like that. I tell you, I got to stop closing my eyes and pay attention to what I'm doing because I just be in the groove, Pamela. But before I bring you in, of course, I want to let all my listening audience know, thank you so much for tuning back into me every Tuesday. Thank you for the new listeners that's joining in because somebody invited you in, that told you that this is a new way to accelerate wellness in your life, to just focus on consciousness, focus on healthcare, leave everything else alone and focus on what it is that you truly want. Don't try to defeat diseases. Just put it over in the corner and say you want to get well. So that's what we're talking about. And so again, this week, we all know that Nest Health has feel good infaceuticals, and it activates your body healing potential. And without having a Nest scan, you can allow yourself to feel good by giving your energy the right information to help it move through the body. But Pamela's going to come on and tell you that no matter what you have, if you don't clean up that cellular environment, that information, that nutrients, that oxygen ain't going to get down there too well. So she's going to share with you. But what I want to say is that energy moves through information. In chaos, there's structure. And so I love the Nest Infaceuticals, the feel-good infaceuticals. Before you can get well, you need to start feeling good. So this week, we're highlighting the Peace Infaceutical because I tell you, family, community, I had to practice a lot of peace this week. So Peace Infaceutical helps promote a calm mental state, mental clarity, and honesty with oneself. It enhances the head-heart connection to help resolve conflicts between emotions and logical thought, as well as memories that have caused disharmony. And I love peace because it brings such a feeling of peace. You know, people say, what is peace? You take peace, you're going to feel peace. You're going to like, damn, I didn't know I was feeling so good. You can always go to my website, consciousselfhealthcare.com. consciousselfcare.com and click on the Feel Good Infaceuticals. There's 17 of them. You can buy all 17 of them. You can just buy one, two, or three, or four, but I guarantee you it will put you on the pathway to correcting that information. See, that's what we do. We move through information. We're going to share some information with you right now. So take a moment as we do it. Be still. Take that deep breath. And today we want you to focus on your chakra, your solar plex, and trust the feeling that you feel. You see, you feel what you feel. Trust that feeling that you feel. Acknowledge what you feel, because that is the true feeling, the essence of who you are, the soul of who you are. We want you to vibrate. Now, not feelings of emotions that got you going all up and down, all around the scale. We're talking about that feeling of knowingness. Trust that feeling of knowingness. So vibrate on that. Have your pen and paper out or do it mentally. I'm going to turn my mic over to Pamela for a few moments. She's going to reintroduce herself to you. And we're going to talk about maximizing cellular potential. And how do you do that? Pamela, welcome back to Heart Healthy Living.
Thank you. Thank you. Good to be back.
Yeah.
And I was thinking we should probably recap a little bit. Briefly over what we went through last week.
I think that would be great. I want to chime in with something you talked about.
Yeah.
We talked about the rules. I want to share a quick story, but go ahead and chime in.
We talked about the healthcare cost today and what we can do to break free from that programming that has been with us for so long that contributes to the production of the diseases that we're so familiar with as we grow up. So what I did after I spoke about that was we went back to the womb, and that is the basic of endless breath and boundless energy. And I say you can't fix something in the middle. You kind of have to go back to the beginning. So I took everybody back to the womb, and with rebounding, we learn how to remember that environment. And then we also learned how we get reprogrammed. And I brought in the concept of the benefits of rebounding and this type of health rebounding and the differences between aerobic rebounding and health rebounding and what we're programmed with, that we need to go a little bit further with that. It's cellular fitness, not physical fitness that counts here. And I led that into maximum cellular potential because one of the most amazing benefits of rebounding, and there is a 30-day program, 1 minute a day, adding 1 minute each day until you reach 30 minutes. It's a formula in the book that leads you to being in breath. And when you are in breath, we don't even know we're out of breath. So we learned how to, in the very basic introduction of health rebounding, that we are not only detoxifying our lymphatic system, removing the excess wet around the cells into a dry state, so that the oxygen can have a direct contact upon exertion. And then that is how you become, as I call it, in breath. And then upon exertion, you get more oxygen, not less. So this takes us into maximum cellular potential. How do we get there? There are so many factors that clog, you know, or distract us from reaching our cellular potential, and we get used to living like that, like human shock absorbers. And one of the things I want to talk about today is a little bit at the end of the last show. I brought in the emotions, and we have emotional toxins, and those are just as important to realize, because that becomes the programming, that becomes the mindset, that becomes the belief system, and it's the truth held within our natures that we don't always think about, but we're all born into a pattern of nature that holds the emotional strengths and weaknesses that I began to speak about last week. And we all learn to respond and react to these strengths and these weaknesses. Now, we want to keep in mind that weakness does not mean, and it's not meant to intimidate our spirit, but to awaken it. It does not mean that you are not capable. It is a point of recognizing that there is something, yet to remember to return to who you truly are and not who you've been influenced to be. And this is the true objective. I spoke a little bit last week about when one begins to bring the trampoline into their home and they have limited amount of knowledge, it's only what they remember or what they see on a video. It's the emotion, it's the ego that does not want you to succeed. If one is already based upon failure or disappointment and they're choosing to bring the mini trampoline into their life, the rebounder, the lymphosizer, and they have this mindset, the emotions are very, very important to remember. The weaknesses. We all want to be better. But how do we reach that maximum cellular potential if we're coming out of a minimum cellular environment? So we bring the emotions in and we recognize our weaknesses. We recognize our failures. We recognize our disappointments.
Emotionally,
because I mentioned last week that, and you know, what I see happen, especially in the medical environment, the illness environment, the disease environment, and being a life coach, I see what happens is that people unconsciously become addicted to getting attention for these weakened emotions. And that becomes a habit. They become used to it. And that's what they
become
go
so
to
get. To it, they don't even know what they're
they
used
don't even know they're doing.
And that's why I often say you have to look and see if you are in a man-made mindset of human kind.
Man-made mindset, yes.
And so that's what you have to look at, family, community. You have to really separate that and say, is this what I'm really thinking? Is this what I'm really feeling? Is this where my emotions really lie at? Or is this just something I've been doing, programming to it, a habit? And once you sit down and actually observe yourself, because we're talking about mental observation view, it's essential for your success. Conscious self-health care means that you are setting back and you are actually looking at your actions and how you apply them. Is that what you're trying to talk about?
Absolutely.
When you talk about emotions?
Absolutely.
Go ahead.
For the callers that are in, I one of my phrases that I use is realize, release, reset, restore, and then your body will respond. So this, again, health rebounding is about participating with your body's ability to respond and restore and rejuvenate on a cellular level. And the emotional state, the mental state has to be in alignment as well. Otherwise, it's, you know, the mind, the body's not going to understand even what it's doing. So to be fully aware, to be fully cognitive of why you are vertically moving up and down, and you understand how the cells respond to being, you know, reignited, and how the oxygen at that point, you can feel it. I'm telling you, within like a few weeks, you know, the first day you get on the rebounder, you're probably out of breath. It's like you have sea legs and you're not used to getting, you know, being on a zero gravity surface, off of a hard surface. You're horizontal movement, not vertical movement. Well, this is vertical movement, and this is that ignition, that tool of ignition to ignite the
ignite. That's what we're talking about. Oxygen, when you're rebounding, when you're lymphocyzing, when you look at a trampoline, not in terms of just jumping and having fun, because that's good for kids and they're really getting what they need. But when
or
you
just
understand.
Another exercise, right.
But when you understand the gravity.
Beyond that.
When you understand the gravity of it, and that means you have got to awaken yourself to understanding the lymphatic system, the guardian angel of your immune system. It's all one system. And this system is the system that if it is not doing its job of purifying the body, then the immune system in its whole self becomes sluggish. And you feel this. And once your system becomes sluggish, it cannot purify itself, then the body starts going through changes, physical changes. And you feel those. And they call those diseases when there are symptoms of sluggishness, cellular malfunction. So if you get nothing from this show today, but one thing you can get is to replace the name of diseases with cellular malfunctions. And then you are empowered to be in control. And this simplistic information that we're giving you that is so complex, really, that it's really so simplistic that when we say just get back to nature and get into vertical movement opposed to horizontal movement, that you will make a shift in cleaning your environment. Because no matter what you're putting into your body, if the physical body does not have the right environment for the cells to receive it, it won't get it. And that's why you have to get cellular fit opposed to
physically
fit.
And
so we're going to take a
last week.
Yeah, right.
Okay. Go ahead.
We're going to take it to the store.
It can't go to the store. Before I forget.
Hold that so you can come back with it. Write that down. We're going to take a station break. I'm going to give everybody the call-in number. We're getting close up on the half an hour, and people can call in and share if you lymphocyze, if you rebound. If you rebounded for lymphocyzing, not just rebounding to exercise, you know the difference. And you want to call in and share, you can. So we're going to take a station break, and I'm going to give you that number. We're going to continue the conversation with Pamela Burscak.
Is it time for a new approach to your health care? Are you ready to lead the dark ages of disease care management and pharmaceuticals? If your answer is yes, Get ready to relearn, rethink, and rewrite your personal healthcare prescription plan with Dr. K. She is a certified lymphologist and Nest Healthcare provider, sharing the new science of information as medicine and cellular ecology. Did you know that the field of epigenetics states that you are more than just your genes, and those genes do not control your biology? Yes, that's correct. Schedule a Skype, phone, or office visit with Dr. K and get on board the friendship train to healthcare freedom. 202-248-7749. That's 202-248-7749. Visit us on the web, forcellife.com. The number 4, the words cell, cellife.com.
Hey. Yes, you are tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living. I'm Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks, broadcasting live from Washington, D.C., downtown Anacostia. My guest is Pamela Burscak. She is a life coach and a lymphologist, and she supports people in many, many different areas. But today, family and community, we're taking you back to basic principles of life. It's not that complicated. You know, science is, medicine is, and understanding physiology and anatomy is, but for you to take care of your being is very simplistic if you would just get out of that arena of all that other stuff, that chaotic stuff, that disease thinking realm. We're talking about just focusing on healthcare, one of the main systems in the body. You have more lymphatic vessels than you have blood vessels. You have the heart that pumps and circulates the circulatory system through the body. But I like to say that your breath is the activating, accelerating point of your lymphatic system. So the deeper you breathe, the more that system is able to do its job. But when you get on a zero point gravity device and accelerate that, because it's a slow moving system, we bombard it with a lot of poison, chemicals, foods that the body doesn't know what the heck to do with it in this day and time. And so it becomes very sluggish, and it holds on to a lot of junk, and it's like a tsunami in your body, and you want to get that cleaned up. And you have these little buckets, your lymphatic system, the buckets trying to clean and move this stuff around and deliver it to the eliminating organs, and it needs your support. So before you can even get totally healthy, you have to get cellular fit. And that's what Pamela and I are sharing with you today. The lymphatic system, once again, is like a tree in the body. The branches go up inside the head. The roots go down in the feet. And the trunk in the chest is called the thoracic duct. Its primary purpose is to vacuum pack the tissues of each vital organ so the bloodstream can breathe each and every cell with abundance of oxygen and nutrients and information so that your body can process itself correctly. It's no mystery. It's no diseases out there that they got to find a cure for. It's you not properly cleansing your body. Think of your fish tank, right, Pamela?
Absolutely.
Think of a fish tank. Think of
what
things that needs to be cleaned.
Stagnant waters become a breeding ground for illness. I mean, if you watch a fish, I mean, if you look at a fish tank and it gets cloudy, those fish are going to die. You know, we were talking about, you know, when the body goes into insufficiency, and I think before the break, I was before I forget that, you know, it cannot go to the store and get what it needs. If you're feeding it, you know, food that is just not real, that's processed. We talked about that. It's not, it's still not getting what it needs, and it will keep hunting throughout its the body systems to get what it needs. And if that falls into failure, then a disorder arrives, and the cells, like Karen talks about, they become weakened and they become vulnerable.
Yes.
So before that happens,
weakened. They don't have enough electricity power to do the job. But you know, it's not dead.
It's
you look
so
like a plant, like
fast.
It's dead, but it's not dead. You give it what it needs, and it can come back to life. You got to clean up your environment. You just can't go out there like you're cleaning up a tsunami and just get these sump pumps and start pulling out. Your lymphatic system is that sump pump. So if you want to really start getting well, you got to get so you're fit first. And like Pamela said, we go out and we get a rebounder, We're talking about a trampoline. We also call it a lymphocyzer. People call it rebounding. But Pamela said, like, you know, you get a rebounder, you see everybody talking about jumping on it, and you get on there and you do what, Pam? They get dizzy.
They get, yeah, they start banging away because as a child, they remember. It's like riding a bike. Oh, I can remember how to bike. I can remember how to do that. But, you know, as they've grown up as, into adults, I mean, they've accumulated a lot of debris along the way. A lot of mental toxins, emotional toxins, you know, body toxins. There's a list a mile long. And they think that they can go back and do what they did before. They will get dizzy. They will get most likely nauseous. And then they will put it down because they don't like that feeling. But they have no knowledge of why it happened to begin with.
There
the
we
body
go.
Was responding to all of those toxins being jostled around, right, you know, too quick, too fast. So in order to get the food, the blood carries the food, the oxygen to those cells – that fluid, that excess toxic fluid, has to be moved away from the body. Good water's coming in, bad water's coming out. Then the body's being prepared. Before I even have a client with life coaching, I prepare them for change.
Yeah,
so this is preparing the body for rejuvenation, for responding to, you know, for responding.
For response, I just got a message that I didn't give out the phone number, and we did have a caller holding on.
Okay.
And I do apologize to the caller because I wasn't looking at the screen, and Brother Jamal did tell me that we had a caller that was holding on for a while. But the calling number is 310-928-7733. Caller, I know you're listening. You can call back in, and we would definitely bring you in on the line to share whatever it is that you want to share with us. 310-928-7733. And I'm going to be paying more attention to my post. I'm watching this.
We're lymphologists together.
I'll be in another zone and I forget. Yeah. You know, you are the host. You're not the guest. So we did have a caller call. And I do apologize to you, caller.
Well, just let me know when they do.
And we like to call back in. You can. And Pamela's here, and we're sharing with you, family, community, that if you truly want to get well, the first thing you have to do is get cellular fit, because you have to be able to allow the information, the nutrients, whatever it is you're trying to bring into your body, that oxygen, to get them pumps going, to create that energy so you can have the power. If the cells cannot receive it because it is in the wet state, and, you know, defining the wet state and the dry state, I just want to let you know that this next series or the next 2 months here on Heart to Heart Healthy Living, I'm going to be having lymphologists come on that have been lymphologists for over 50 years, 40 years, 30 years. They're going to come in and share with you the basic information.
Static story.
What they've been doing in their practices. Yeah. This is what they've been trying to share with you. That it, until you realize this is your power, this is how you are able to self-conscious healthcare by knowing about this system and how to activate it, to purify it, to get it out the wet state, to get it out that state where the tissues become so hardened that you feel like they want to cut them off. They don't need to. They need you to get things circulated. That's the power of the breath. That's the power of the lymphatic system. You have your own built-in mechanism to – that's why you have more lymphatic vessels than blood vessels. But we're going to have
– you can bring this into your home. I mean, you can, you know, if I owned a business, brick and mortar, the first thing I would have would be this program to bring this in with every one of my employees, as I would with my family members. And there would be rebounders all around.
Break time, the smoke time. We do have a caller on the line, and here I go with trying to pronounce these names.
It's Khadijah. No worries. Sometimes I forget how to pronounce my own name.
How do people say, well, can't you see what it says? You should be able to pronounce it, but if you don't have
it, I can see it.
But I don't want to mess up your name. Thank you for calling.
No, that's okay, sis.
Your name again, sister.
It's Khadijah, but people call me Dia. No worries.
Dia, I know. Okay, great for calling in. What you want to share with us, sister?
I just want to thank y'all for having this wonderful show. And I also am glad that you guys mentioned the psychology, the way that people think, because that's where healing begins. In American society, we have been bamboozled and brainwashed and emotionally indoctrinated into a way of being from our families, from the images in media, from the ambassadors for that institution, school, everything. You're constantly indoctrinated. Yes. So, you know, because we're so clogged up mentally, it not only spiritually, I mean, health-wise clogs us up, it spiritually clogs us up and doesn't allow us to see what we need to see and also move the things that we need to move within our own frame. And it's very unfortunate. And also, it helps us to move from an emotional place, which is not always a good vibration. And I think that humanity really plays upon that. They play upon the dark aspects of reality of mind, so we can move in that energy and constantly be sick, constantly mentally be sick.
Expected.
We're a psychologically sick nation. And
we're not feeling it.
Yeah, that's why I often say to make that very simplistic for people. It's like, are you working from a man-made mindset of human consciousness? And what is that? That's your life beliefs. That's your parents. That's your schooler. That's your preacher. That's your teacher. That's your candle, your bookmaker. I don't care.
And what did I say last week about the industries making more money off of what we've forgotten than what we've remembered? And they count on you not paying attention, not getting educated. And they, like when I say the laws of nature don't care if you know, we deviate or not, the industries do, you know, they want you to stay, you know, dumbed down.
Nature is no person. They don't care how much education you got. If you don't move them lymphatic vessels, if you don't breathe, if you don't nourish the body right, you're going to get the same thing. Karen, you're going to get the same thing. If you don't do what you're saying to other people, Pamela, you're going to get the same thing. And Rodia, you're going to get the same thing.
Those principles and those formulas are written in stone. And that is the way it stays until, you know, you break away or you realize, you know, what your full potential is, what your maximum cellular potential is, your mental potential.
I like what you talked about last week, Pamela. I like the way you talk about your internal identity.
And we forgot about that. Yes.
We got
the end.
You have to stay with your internal identity.
Yes, those internal identity wounds.
We get all these external identities.
Internal. They're internal identity wounds.
Internal.
That the external familiar behavior that you attract yourself to keeps reopening those wounds. And that's what becomes familiar, which becomes a vicious cycle of attracting yourself to that same type of behavior or that same type of thinking or that same type of lack of healing. And that is, you know, that is a power. I mean, that's all one knows.
It's
and that
very
identity
powerful.
Wound is there ready. You know, it may be scarred over, but because of that consistent, you know, remembered behavior from those experiences from your childhood on up, if those experiences haven't been broken, those cycles haven't been broken, then they will keep reopening those wounds. And that is
That's why you have to get out of this man-made mindset of human consciousness. Just sit back and be still. Now, everybody, let's all just take a moment and let's breathe, because we are being still and we are absorbing this information to help us vibrate to a high frequency to relieve the thought that I have to find a way to crush symptoms of a disease. These are symptoms of cellular malfunction. Your cells are not receiving what they need. Family and community is very simplistic. Every cell rejuvenates itself based on how you think and what you feed it on a daily basis. Every organ rejuvenates itself in a certain amount of time. And go out and do some work. Go out there and Google for good health and find out how cells, you're not deemed to the cells you have today. Unless you treat them the same way, they will come back the same way. You have the opportunity of changing your life right now. I don't care how sick you feel, how you in third stage, fourth stage, final stage, or whatever stage. When you change your vibration and change your consciousness, shift that energy. shifted by how you're acting, what you're doing. And then, you know, then get a body what it needs, because it is a physical body, right, ladies?
Go by a trampoline.
It's a physical body, right, ladies? And if you don't get this body to have an excess of waste in it, it's going to shut you down, because that's all it is.
Sick, they don't want to move. That's the thing they should do is move.
Move.
You get a call, get down there on that trampoline. If you get down there and get those fluids moving.
But D, I think you wanted to share something. What did you want to say?
No, I'm going to say one more thing, and then I'm going to listen to you girlies off the line. And thank you for calling me Raw Dia, because Raw is the bomb. I do have
that. No, see how she did that? I like Raw Dia. Is that?
Yeah, I love that.
That is the sun god, and I am the sun goddess. So work it out, sis. I'm mad at you. But I just wanted to say as well that, you know, I think that the reason why it's very difficult for individuals to step forward and to do action and to do exactly what you beautiful ladies are speaking of is because the hegemony, the majority of society, meaning the powerful institutions, really have people strung out on this euphoric feeling of negativity.
Sure.
So when one tries to step out of that space in a physical space, a spiritual space, they literally have you on spiritual and physical lockdown. They got people watching TV like nobody's business. And let me tell you, they do have scientific research on the frequency that comes out of the television, literally keeps you locked.
Hypnosis.
Yes.
It
keeps you locked in your body when you go to sleep.
Seduced.
It keeps you seduced on a 24-hour level. So, you know, people are really, this is like an addiction, like drugs, like alcohol. So I thank you for speaking on it and keep speaking on it, because I think that, you know, it takes 21 days to create a new habit.
Hey.
So if you just keep speaking on it, it will
soak. Our 30-day formula. You'll be completely renewed after 30 days.
Goodbye. So
it's just like Emmett Fox says, right through a pause in the conscious will eventually purify. Just keep pouring it in. You'll get there.
That's right. So keep pouring it in.
Thank you so much.
Keep doing your thing, and I send you all a lot of love, and I'll
listen. Thank you for that confirmation.
Thank you so much. We're honored. Thank you so much. Yeah. All right. We appreciate that. So, yeah, we're talking to you about the lymphatic system. I'm going back to basics. I'm going back to just simple information that no matter what you're trying to do, no matter what modalities you are using, no matter whatever you're using, you must become cellular fit. We're talking about cellular lymphatic wellness. Most of you know that I founded Emancipate Yourself from Medical Mental Slavery Day. That's April 30th every year. On this show right here, I am announcing, I wanted to do it this year, but with the loss of my mother and the things that I have been going through, I didn't pull it off like I wanted to. But I'm going to announce that starting next year, 2016, April is going to be Lymphatic Cellular Wellness Month. We're not talking about the conditions of the lymphatic system, the disease names. We're talking about cellular lymphatic wellness, because we need a wellness month. We need a month where you can rejuvenate yourself, regenerate yourself, and just get your body to actually create a new energy, new electricity. So we're not going to have a disease month. We're having a cellular lymphatic wellness month. We want you to come out, pull out your trampolines. We want you to lymphatize on them for cellular wellness. Call it rebounding. Call it jump up and down. Call it having fun. Whatever you want to call it. We want to be doing that throughout the year. We're going to come together in April and around the world, wherever you are, have a lymphatic party and tell everybody to get well. Right, Pamela?
Absolutely.
We're going to call it maximizing cellular potential.
Maximum cellular potential. Realize, release, restore, so you can participate with your body responding.
And what you call those R's? How many R's you have in there?
The R's. I have a lot of R's. Realize your situation.
Realize
what is no longer beneficial.
So are you in a man-made mindset of conscious, or are you willing to vibrate yourself into something new and have your people around you vibrate to where you are, so that you dropping back down into the low frequencies?
I mean, rebounding is you know, a returning. It's a returning. You know, you must return, and that's why it's such a beautiful word, and it's a reword. It's another reword. You know, we have to, if we're doing the same thing over and over and not getting the response that we're happy with, we have to change that. We have to revise that. We have to remember. I mean, there's so many re's. I have a whole book just on re's. but those are my favorites. Realize, release, reset, restore. And if you forget, you get into a situation where you're confused, you just start all over. You return.
Look, Pat, we're coming up close on. We're coming up close on the hour. We're going to take another commercial break. Pamela, when you come back, I want to make sure that you give people all the information on how they can reach you. And I'm going to try to bring all this into a clear understanding when we come back. And so, Jamal, let's take that final commercial break. And we're going to come back and bring everything to a clear understanding.
Are you at your wit's end because there seems to be no solution to your healthcare problem? Is it okay for me to say to you that you can have peace of mind? Take back control of your health. Are you experiencing anxiety, arthritis, diabetes, cancer, fibromyalgia, high blood pressure, lupus, chronic fatigue syndrome, any fictitious disease? Whatever your symptoms or diagnosis are, there is a conscious solution to transform the cause of your pain. Not treat symptoms or mask it. No prescription medication, no over-the-counter drugs, no organs removed are required. Take back control of your health by the renewing of your mind. You can create wellness today. Contact Dr. K, 202-248-7749. Visit us on the web, www.sellclife.com.
Yes, indeedy, family community. You're tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living. I'm Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks. You call me Dr. K. I'm broadcasting live from Washington, D.C. in historical Anacostia. Just want to remind everybody that my definition of disease is an inharmonious condition in mind and body brought about by error thinking. Ignorance is causes all diseases. It says my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, internal knowledge, who you really are. Organic disease has its origin in mind as truly as any other manifestation. It has become subconscious and needs the power of your higher thinking mind to reach and to dissolve the error thoughts that are causing the disease. So it's a thought of a disease that you're trying to correct that is false. You create cellular malfunctions. This body has laws. It governs it. And if you live those laws and stay away from destructive man-made chemicals, you will live a more better, more harmonious life. Family, community, and I'm telling you, activate your lymphatic system. Get out into nature. Hug a tree. Walk barefooted. Get back into feeling the nature, just the vibration of the earth. And that alone will clear up that information. That alone will help circulation start to increase. It's very simplistic. Don't be afraid to do simplistic things, right, Pamela?
No. Oh, my goodness. If once you can breathe in breaths naturally without stimulants, without counterfeit, caffeine and all that, that's amazing. That is just absolutely – take your rebounders out to your decks. Take them outside. Make them available. Make sure.
I'm glad you said that because –
You need to make – keep them within your sight. And there's nothing more beautiful to go out in the morning at sunset, sunrise. I've gone out in the middle of the night with the stars, get up in the morning, with the sunrise and rebound. Oh my gosh. And then it's just anytime, any place.
Hey, Pamela, I want the community to come rebound with me in Washington, D.C.
I want to do that.
You
just tell me when and I'll be on a flight. I'm going to come.
We're at the Anacostia Smithsonian Museum on Mars Road at the 2nd and 4th Saturday of the month. Call me. Get the information, 202-248-7779. Sure. And come out and join us outside and lymphocyte. Pam, tell us, because we're coming up on the hour. No, we got to go exactly at 7 o'clock. Tell the community I can reach the Facebook group.
Well, now the Facebook group is Rebounding for Life. If you have a problem getting there, then you come to my profile, Pamela Burscak, B-U-R-C-S-A-K. And my website is reboundingforlife.com. If you'd like to get a copy of Endless Breath, Boundless Energy, if you bypass Facebook, not everybody's on it. It is there on the front page. And that will take you back to the very beginning, back to the womb, and the very, introduction to rebounding.
This is not the last time you will hear Pamela. We're going to have Dr. Nathan Rabb coming up next on Heart to Heart. He is a lymphologist for over 40 years, I believe. He's going to share with us how he has incorporated that in his community. We're going to have Professor Carl West, Dr. Sanders' son's son. He's going to come on. His other son is going to come on, and other lymphologists. Yeah. And we're going to keep breaking it down to you very basic about how to get well and remove yourself from disease thinking. Come on, family community. It's time to step up out of the dark ages of being a victim.
And become a beyonder on a rebounder. That's a whole nother story.
Yes. I want to invite the community to go to my website, forsalelife.com. That's number four, forsalelife.com. There's a book out there that you can download, Healing Yourself and Others by Mastering Energy and Information. A lot of us know about energy, but we're talking about information that governs and moves energy. And we want to leave you with one formula. It came from a 37-step formula from Dr. Samuel C. West, the founder of the International Academy of Lymphology. He brought it down to these very simple words: oxygen pumps your cells equals electricity equals power. So if you're not feeling any power in your body, you got to go back to oxygen. You got to go back to those pumps. You got to go back to the zero state. You got to get out of the wet state into the dry state, and you do that by the power of the lymphatic system. Take that deep breath and vertical movement. And you know what? You can do vertical movement with walking. We'll teach you how to do that.
Sit on the edge of your bed. You in your car. Bounce your car. Somebody does road rage, just start bouncing up and down. It'll work. Do it all the time.
It's a shift in energy. It's a shift in consciousness. You don't give your power to people, places, and things, family, community, and friends. You are in control of your life. I'm telling you what to do. You know, I love, you know, when you talked about Pamela, the wound, because it starts in the wound. It starts for the wound. And I want to say to the family community, when you go out to my website, there's a section out there they call Remembrance. I do what I do as a lymphologist because of my son. Born 1 pound, 5 ounces. And the doctors told me that he had a strong heart. But I said, damn, he mighty limp. I never knew that I would become a lymphologist, understood what happened to my son. So that environment, that wound that the baby is in, that water, it must be purified. It must be loving. It must be good. It must be nourishing, because my son wasn't in good fluid. He wanted to leave. And I did the McDonnell Douglas stitch and kept him here. And so he wasn't in a good environment for lymphocytes. And that water is so important. Your children come out and they know that vibration. They want that vibration, and it has to be purified, and we need to get back to it. So love yourself, honor yourself, embrace yourself. Take a moment and be still and ask yourself, are you working from a man-made mindset of human consciousness? Don't be a victim to society. Don't be a victim to your genes. Raise your vibration. You are mightier than that.
Yes, you are.
Every human being is mightier than that. No one is over anyone else. You all got the power to relearn, rethink, and rewrite your own healthcare paradigm. Thank you so much for tuning into Heart to Heart. Pamela, I know you are part of the community now. We are going to be talking again. Thank you for all that you do. Your book, Boundless. We're talking about what? Say the name of your book, Pam.
Oh, Endless Breath, Boundless Energy. Yes.
And you talk about the in breath. You talk about the in breath at X. When you reach that level of exertion, you should be in breath.
This manual is timeless. It is the very basic introduction to health rebounding from the very beginning, and it starts at the womb.
Come
and
on,
I bring you forward. And it's written on a very, very elementary level. I go back to when we were kids.
Yeah, so mine incorporates a lot, Pamela. My book is The Dark Ages of Healthcare. I go over the signs that Dr. West shared with us. I talk about the 7 major discoveries. I share information with you about the disease care system, and then I lead you into the lymphatic system, lymphocyzing, and then I lead you into informational medicine. There's a new frontier coming. Bioenergetic practitioners going to be on the front end to help you understand the power of your consciousness and how you can shift that vibration, shift that energy, and then give your body what it needs. The physical body is only here by what it needs physically to be here. Your soul or who you are does not need this physical body. So when it lays to rest, it's going to keep going on and on and
on.
It never dies. But this physical body has information that it needs, physical things that it needs, and it starts with a purifying body. The less mucus, the less waste you have in this body, the better it performs. So get the waste out, get the mucus out, get the excess fluid out, excess sodium out, lymphocyte, deep breathe. Get on that trampoline and know that you're not just rebounding and jumping up and down exercising. We're talking about cellular fitness.
Way beyond.
Way beyond. So my information on, you can go to, like I said, Conscious Self Healthcare, 1S connects conscious and self. And check out all the information on the latest frontier in healthcare. For Sale Life is an educational website. It's 1,000 links out there. Because when somebody called me and said they wanted to know something, I said, go out and read, explore, learn, advance yourself, and then come back and have a conversation, because you're stuck in an old paradigm of thinking. Like Pamela was talking about earlier, you have to ask yourself, where are you working from right now to get what you want to get to? And are you working from something old, trying to do something new? And that's why you didn't reach it yet. So we're talking about mental observation view is essential for your success. So I want you to tune in next week. We're going to have many, many guests on to share this information with you. Oh, but you know what? I wanted to ask the community. Are y'all aware that last week that the FDA has now strengthened the language for Motrin, Advil, and Tylenol to say that it no longer may cause heart attack and strokes, that it does cause heart attack and stroke immediately within 1 week of taking them? And just imagine how long y'all been taking that over-the-counter medication. Okay, now you know why you need to get lymphatically fit.
So you can separate yourself from that paradigm.
Separate yourself from that paradigm. And we ain't even going to talk about the doctor in Michigan that was running around telling everybody they had cancer, 550 patients. And Dr. Fata, running around trying to make money. So who do you believe? Believe yourself. Trust your internal identity. Trust that intuition. Trust that feeling. Remember, we're on that chakra today. Trust what you feel and get out of the disease thinking, feel, the body is going to lay down the rest one day, but it doesn't have to lay down the rest from a disease. Okay? Natural causes is a wonderful thing to go.
Be aware of what you've got blind faith in. That's very important. It's not always, that's not one of our benefits.
I like what you said today, though. Healthy sound. That's a good way to talk about rebounding, because most people rebound and they get tired of exercise. And so we're saying don't exercise on the length, on the rebounder, lymphocyte, get cellular fit.
Yes.
And if healthy rebounding, because you're thinking in terms of being cellular fit so that you can be in breath.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
And reach your maximum cellular potential.
Right. Yeah. 1 minute to close it. What you want to share, Pamela? What you want to say?
Well, I am so happy to be able to speak with you for the last 2 weeks, and I know there'll be many, many more, and I'll be happy to see you when you come to Ohio, and hopefully that's where it's at, when you come to the Great Lakes, and I would just love to get on the plane and bring my rebounder with me and join you.
Yes!
Yes. Oh, why shouldn't I?
You can help me promoting April as being Lymphatic Cellular Wellness Month.
I will be there.
Through the International Academy of Lymphology, we're going to just spread that word that April is a positive month for conscious self-health care.
Yes.
Family and community, we love you. I'm going to leave you with this statement in honor of my mother, Shirley R. Hardy. I've established a senior urology program. It's international. It's not just limited to Washington, D.C. I can help you around the world, no matter where you are, because that's how remote you are. We can support each other from anywhere. We want to thank you for tuning into Heart to Heart Healthy Living. And my mother said, beliefs. You want your beliefs to change. It's proof that you are keeping your eyes open, living fully and welcoming, that the world and the people around you can teach you. This means that people's beliefs should evolve as they gain new experiences. Shirley R. Hardy. My mother wrote this as she shifted her energy from disease care to conscious self-health care. She said, beliefs and doubts are learned. Disease is a belief system. Family and community, wake up. You have cellular malfunctions and you can't. Thank you for tuning into Heart to Heart Healthy Living. Thank you, Pamela. Thank you. That's our guest. We appreciate you for tuning in every Tuesday and spread the word. It's time to bury disease thinking.